are the top 10 most influential people in the contemporary art world, you can find them in the ranking that Art Review set up each year with the top 100 people trending now in the art world. At the top of those, we have Gavin Brown, Bruno Latour, Thelma Golden, Ivan and Manuela Pirth, Hans Ulrich Olbrich, David Birner, Adam Simsic, Donna Haraway, Pierre Wig, and the number one is Ito Steger. Okay, now, for those wondering who are them, who are those ones, I am going to explain it in this video. Ito Steger is a German artist. Normally, she makes video installations showing us her vision on contemporary world and the role that art and artists are playing in the current culture. Indeed, she likes very much to talk, to say, and to explain her works. She considers herself an intellectual so much as an artist. She invents concepts and theories about any topic. It's very difficult to tell apart what she says seriously from what she says in jest. At the end of this video, you can find an example of what she does. Pierre Wig is a French artist. He creates complex installations mixing all the artistic means you can imagine. He also considers himself an intellectual and tries to explain the role artist plays in the contemporary society. He claims that his artworks are not perceived as fiction but as reality. In his last exhibition at the MoMA, he left a lost dog wandering among visitors. All his installations are full of reference to another artist and philosophers, and full of reference to important artworks along the art history. This summer, for the sculpture project in Münster, he creates an installation with bees, seaweeds, and peacocks interacting in an ecosystem controlled by him, connected to an incubator containing bacteria and cancer cells. Some sensors monitored the entire life process during the time the exhibition lasted. Donna Haraway is a distinguished American professor emerita in the history of consciousness at the University of California. She is a prominent scholar in the field of feminism, artificial intelligence, and animal behavior, especially from primates. She was graduate in zoology and philosophy, since she published her Herbivore Manifesto in 1984. She has been and continues to be a source of inspiration for artists, curators, galleries, and art collectors. She considers that there are no limits in the nature that allow us to tell apart machines and animals from men. Adam Simsic is the most sought-after curator for contemporary art exhibitions. He has been in charge of organizing the Documenta 14 this summer. The select works were divided in two venues, the usual one in Kassel and the other one in Athens. The purpose was to reflect different aspects of the migratory crisis in Europe, to show the values of any of anti-capitalism and to discuss the contradiction of globalized cultural tourism. The extra cost of the assembly in Athens reached 7 million euros. David Birner is the owner of a World Empire of Art Galleries that in 2018 will open in Hong Kong for entering the Chinese art market, where it really is the future of contemporary art. About the Arab sheikhs buying artworks, I think it has less future. David Birner works in connection with critics, editors, and art historians. He also has invested in Arta, the online shipping art platform. Hans Ulrich Olbrich is another of those star curators in demand from any contemporary art museum all over the world to stage exhibition with the last of the last in trending artistic creation. He is the art director of Serpentine Galleries in London, but this is only one of the many things he does. Just now he has signed for Luma Foundation as advisor. This foundation from Zurich, Switzerland, is dedicated to promote and support young emerging artists. Ivan and Manuela Birth, this married couple, are the owners of one of the most important art gallery in the world, the Hauser & Birth. Manuela's mother is Ursula Hauser, the famous art collector. This woman fought with the Sandinistas in Nicaragua in the 80s, and she married a Tupamaro guerrilla who was the father of her daughter Manuela. Ursula is Marxist, Maoist, and multimillionaire. Her fortune came from being the owner together with her brother Walter of the Fuchs AG company, the largest firm of household appliance and service in Switzerland. About the topic of art and business, I suggest you to watch this video I uploaded last year and this another one. The Hauser & Wirth is the gallery that more works in promoting artists like Paul McCarthy, whose piece of art show everything may cause nausea in the viewers, and Philip Guston, who claims to be the worst painter in the art history. Thelma Golden is the director of the Studio Museum in Harlem, New York. She is also an intellectual and art theoretician that works as social and cultural activist. She considers that black people has been marginalized and discriminated at the USA. She also works at the Obama Foundation, and she is also working for the Museum of Contemporary Art in Los Angeles. She is also advisor for New York Committee on Cultural Affairs. Bruno Latour is a French philosopher and sociologist. His numerous essays on our current society are a source of inspiration for artists and art curators all over the world. This man considers that the world is getting out of hand slowly, and if we don't take action, all this will end badly. In addition, he considers that there are not many hopes to avoid the collapse. He thinks that men are living beings in evolution, and there is no difference between animals, machines, and men. He rejects the difference between there and here. He thinks that men are the most dangerous and harmful factor working in the nature. His famous theory on actor red can be summarized like this: may someone does something, please. As you see, all these influential people is usually surrounded by books. To reach that media put a microphone in front of you and people listen to you, you have to read, inform yourself, study, think. And finally, we have Gavin Brown. He's a gallerist that has decided to open his space of exhibition in Harlem. When someone does something like this, he's either foolish or supremely confident in his exhibition game. Gavin Brown is the latter. A big part of the gallery's job is to have dreams and promote his favorite artists. I don't know if this has something to do with art, but this is part of the gallery's task, and Gavin Brown works very well in this stage. And we have arrived to the end. Thanks for watching. If you like this video, put thumbs up, please. And if you want to know more about art, art history, or contemporary art, subscribe my channel. There will be a new video each week, every Sunday at 7:30. Ito Steyer es una de las artistas más influyentes actualmente en el arte contemporáneo. En sus obras mezcla el humor, la ironía y la filosofía. No es fácil distinguir lo que dice en broma de lo que dice en serio. Uno de los conceptos que maneja es el de circularidad. Para explicarlo es mejor poner un ejemplo. En uno de sus vídeos aparecen las cubiertas o carcasas de balas y misiles que han sido disparados en la guerra de Afganistán. La empresa que fabrica esos misiles es la compañía americana General Dynamics, que es uno de los patrocinadores del Museo Walker Art Center de Minneapolis, Minnesota, que es quien ha organizado y pagado la exposición de Ito Steyer en la que se muestra este vídeo de las carcasas de los misiles.